Yeah, my name's Greg. A little bit about me. I always think of myself as an optimistic pessimist, which basically means my glass might be half empty, but I'm just glad there's something in the fucker, to be honest. I'm single as well at the moment, right? And being single through lockdown was hard. I ended up doing some stupid shit through lockdown, right? I ended up dyeing my hair dark, like black. But I did that, right? I did that before I knew my beard. And now, obviously, some of you at the back maybe not know this magic, my beard comes through ginger. So, dark hair, ginger beard, ended up looking like a fucking Jaffa cake. So, next lockdown, let's see where we're at. I can turn myself into an Oreo. So, yeah, I'm single at the moment. And hanging by it, I've immediately forgotten absolutely everything that I was reading about then. Ollie called on me last minute, so I drove down my set.
Blame me! Don't blame me!
It's entirely your fault, Ollie, I'm blaming you. So, I'm single at the moment, and I got talking to one of the girls at work about single life, and she told me, Brian, that she was self-partnering. Now, I had no idea that self-partnering was a thing. It turns out, for those of you that don't know, self-partnering is something that people over 30 do when they end on your friends. But she does it. She takes herself out for meals. She goes, it's a bit attractive to me. To me, self-partnering just sounds like a pretentious way of saying I masturbate a lot. Frankly, I'm not going to go find her as it is. It's a bit tragic, it really is. But, lockdown had me sort of missing those big blowout nights out. I was really, really missing big blowout nights out, where you go out, nightclub, drinking Millowners, blue, shit. You can still taste for about 3 days after. But I'm a little bit, I've dressed well, so you can't really tell, but I am a little bit doughy at the moment, right? So, my big blowout nights out, we're immediately followed the morning after by the hangover breakfast. Now the hangover breakfast, as we all know, McDonald's breakfast, right? Every single, it's the only cure, it's the only, you need a McDonald's breakfast. And I just missed that. I miss going through the McDonald's drive-thru, hearing the little speaker box, just being like, what do you want? And me just being like, mate, you're going to have to sort me out with a sausage and regret and muffin. Because I'm a fucking mess. It really is. It's just one of them. And those one nights, those big nights out, I'm single, trying to hit the town, trying to pull them. I mean, I don't know how the fucking hell I'm pulling now, from a 2 meter distance. Didn't pay attention to me, it was a it's not a thing, is it? But, pre-pandemic, let's rewind. And it did just lead to these big nights out, where one night stands sometimes happen. And, one night stands so well and good, I'm a liberal person. And I say things happen often, they don't. I'm lying for comedic effect. But the thing is, right, when me and sex, I tend to go a bit vacant. I'm ejaculated, I've come, I've fucked right off. I'm on great planet, right? It's a beautiful, happy, lovely, pink fluffy place to be, and it's just really nice. But that gets misread. Right? That gets misread, and women seem to think that I'm a deep thinker. And they think, he's staring into space. Let's ask him what he's thinking. And that, to be honest with you, is never a good idea. Point one, I haven't got a filter between brain and math, so I will splurge out the first thing that won't make any sense, and you'll be left bewildered and probably astonished at what's going on in my face. Point two, I don't think it's your place to ask me what I'm thinking, when I've just blazed you like a fucking donut. Now, the first time this happened, right, She sort of snuggled into my shoulder, which is nice, it's a nice place to be. Come and sit down. We're all friends.
Thank you.
Now she sort of gave me the eyes, give me a look. Give me a little giggle, it's really sweet, man. And she went, what are you thinking?
No, I'm just...
If there is an infinite number of parallel universes, does one exist where I am actually happy? Some of my jokes are a bit sad. It happened again not too long after, right? And she did the same thing. I found myself in that situation where, you know, I fuck off on the little world of my own. And she did the same thing, she snuggled into my shoulder. Little deal, really cute. What do you think? I was just wondering, right? What if an ostrich is just a chicken?